What's going on, guys? It is, I don't know. May 24th, Thursday. Not a lot going on today. I stopped by an e-waste bin, got a couple free things. I don't know if they're worth anything. There's a lot of remotes. And I got to go to the Goodwill outlet store, the shop Goodwill, because I won two auction items. One's an SNES game that I'm going to keep for my collection, and the other's a board game that I sniped for 10 bucks. I'm not going to pay the shipping on it, and it looks like it sells for about $45.50, so that's kind of cool. Anyways, before I head out to that, I'll show you guys what I got in this box from the e-waste bin. Here it is, all nicely packed in this Home Depot box, which actually it's nice too. I need a box about that size, and it is... I think it's a DVD player. I haven't actually fully gone through this yet. It's a DVD player. It's got the funky, like, proprietary output for your sound system and HDMI out. I don't see any. Yeah, there's no other outputs. That's just HDMI out. Which is kind of weird because it doesn't play Blu-rays, but plays DVDs, probably just upscales them. Oh my god, that's heavy. So the next thing is this subwoofer. It's... look how dirty that is. Ew. Oh, I made a sad face. So yeah, LG. It's got the wire to hook the sub up to the DVD player. Oh, there you go. There's the video out component out for the DVD player. There's the speakers, or the speaker out, I should say, front speaker out. I don't have anything that'll fit in those front speaker out. Optical in. What else we got? Antenna, AM, FM. Oh, XM satellite in. So I think I'll probably sell those two together, maybe separately. Someone might want them for parts, I guess. All right, I had to put my camera down for a second to be able to pick that sub up. And then it came with a bunch of remotes. I assume this is probably the DVD remote. I'll look up the price of it. I might include it with the DVD player. I might sell it separately. Who knows? I'll have to see if I can even test the DVD player and sub. Hopefully some sound comes out of the sub. RCA remote. I'm going to guess this is worth nothing because I would almost guarantee that they're probably just typical... that's a little dog hair. They're probably just typical... like cable box remotes. Oh, all this stuff was free though. And another RCA. That might actually be a TV remote. It looks older. A bunch of AAA batteries. I'll check the batteries too, see if they're good. I actually need some more AAAs. And some Christmas lights. My wife wanted to get Christmas lights last year, but I said no because our house wasn't finished. Let's see if these work. It's a little rusty. Unplug my phone here. Plug these in. Do we have... oh, they're working. Oh, kind of. I don't know if they're all working. Yeah, I think they're all working. It's just shove them in where it's darker there. Cool. These I'm not going to sell. I'll just throw them in the Christmas bin. My wife can have more Christmas lights for Christmas. All right, so I got everything hooked up here. This actually plugs in. God, that's dirty on the top. And that's what powers this device, the speakers, everything. So let's find out if it works. I don't see much happening. Oh, there we go. Welcome. Booting. Sounds like there's a DVD in there. Mobile. Alright, so I got my CD there. I'm going to test. Just test the optical drive. It's actually just a music CD, but that should be okay. It should still say playing and everything, just to make sure the optical drive works. I hear it spinning, so I know the drive spins up. I don't know if the laser will read the disc or not. I'm curious if this sub will make any thumping without the speakers hooked up. Is this the volume, maybe? Like this. Oh, look at that. Turn it up and down, you spin your finger on this. That's kind of cool. That's a neat little feature that I'm surprised still works with how dirty it is. I don't like touch things, though, because you end up touching all this, and it makes it just more dirty. I don't hear any thump-a-thumps from the sub. I'll make sure the sub connector's hooked up solidly. All right, so I can see the CD is playing, and I can hear the bass. I don't know if you guys can hear that coming through. Crank her up. Max. See if select works.
Also, a great 90s rock band, I might add. I'm not sure how you switch tracks. I would assume that switches tracks, but I don't know.
See if that remote actually works.
Batteries in it? Of course not. Two double A's it looks like.
How lucky are we gonna get?
There's some double A's in this remote. Let's see if... Uh-oh, one's a no-name. Let's see if they work. Uh-oh, I don't see any lights. Oh, it works. All right. Cool. That's a nice little setup. It's almost a shame there's no speakers to go with this. Hell, I'd... What kind of inputs does it have on the back? Auxiliary in? Yeah, hell. I'd use this for my little upstairs stereo with all my video game consoles. You can hear it thumping away. There's a good amount of bass to that. It sounds a little rattly right now just because of all the crap sitting on the desk and shaking it around, but that's cool. Just look up some prices on this thing. Alright, hopefully you guys can see this. I tried looking up comps. All I could find for solds was the front speakers, which 21 bids, $31 plus 24 to ship. Those are actually clean looking speakers too. There's nothing else. That's it. The rest is car parts. So I'm more confident. Maybe I'll take more of the name and I'll just go LG with the model number. I'm even more confident in parting it out because there is no parts. That can be a good or bad thing, but seeing as there's that many bids on those speakers, clearly people know what this model is. Oh, my phone's taking forever because I'm on office Wi-Fi and because stupid updates. God, every time I want to look something up on this phone, it's going through updates and it just slows everything down. Or it's my work internet. Our Wi-Fi here sucks. It's terrible. Doesn't matter though, I won't be here too much longer, right? There we go. There's the circuit board, 45. Speaker, internal speaker replacement, speaker board, remote for 15, replacement speaker, remote for 30. That's it for active. I wonder if any of those have sold. Check out completed here. Oops. Now I'm clicking things I don't need to. So we got those speakers again, $31 with the bits, the board, nothing on the... Oh, the remote sold for 30. That's cool. And then we get into things that have nothing to do with the stereo. I think I'll part it out. I think what I'll do is I'll probably list the player for like 25 plus shipping, maybe, or 30 plus shipping with the remote since the remote sells for 30. And then like the sub 25, 30 bucks plus shipping too. So maybe make 60 bucks off this stuff. Or you know what? Maybe I'll include the remote. Maybe I'll ask a little more including the remote. I know I can make more if I separate the remote, but I'll probably get stuck with the DVD player. Or maybe I'll try all three without the speakers, because obviously I don't own the speakers, and just sit on it and see what happens. And if they don't sell after a month, I'll break them down into parts. But I'll give you guys an update on what happens with it. So the last thing I got to do here, it's only midday, I got to come back to the office, but I'm going to go down to Shop Goodwill. I'm going to pick up all that stuff I got. Well, the two whole items. Maybe I'll browse around the bins. I really don't like the bins, but maybe I'll take a quick peek, see if I get anything neat out of there. Okay, I'm currently dying in the truck because I have the AC off, but I wanted to quickly show you guys this. Oh man, I haven't had it in so long. I stopped at Sammy Slovakia is what the place is called, and these are Greek fries. It's basically a... Shut up, car. It's basically a Greek salad put onto fries. Oh, so good. I'm here. Goodwill Outlet Center. This parking lot is always full. There's nowhere to ever park. I actually parked on the grass because I didn't have a choice. So I'm going to go in, get my auction winnings. Maybe find some stuff. Alright, so I finished at the Goodwill, or at the weigh-in pay, or whatever you want to call it. And I ended up going through the bins. I didn't want to. I feel dirty, like I need a shower now. But it's all back there. I got a ton of stuff. I got like probably
15-20 PC games, typewriter, a couple other things, but all in all, it was like $36 spent. I probably got, I don't know, about $100, $150 worth of stuff, give or take. I haven't gone through it all yet and looked up prices. But yeah, so I got a bunch. When I get back to the office, I'll show you guys what I got. All right, guys, I am back from the weigh-in pay. It is so hot out today. I don't know what the temperature is, but I hate it. I hate this heat. I miss my cold weather. Most of you people probably hate me saying that, but I do. I miss the cooler weather. It's so hard to work in this humidity. But anyways, I'm back from the weigh-in pay. I figured I'd show you everything I got. Starting with the two things that I won on Goodwill's eBay store, the Southwestern Ontario eBay store, I guess. So the first one was Porky's Pig for the SNES completed box. The box is pretty beat up, but that's okay. It's got the insert, game card, manual, so it's complete. This though, I paid $14 for it, which isn't a bad deal. It's not an amazing deal, but this is just gonna go in the collection. Because for those of you who don't know, I'm a big video game collector. The next thing I won at the Goodwill auction, this is for resale. It's Scrabble Diamond Edition. It's a portable Scrabble game. These sell for about $35 to $40 used. I won it on auction for $10. No one bidded on it. I won it last night, and obviously I paid no shipping because I picked it up. I think what scared people away is Goodwill's shipping price. They had like $33 shipping on this, so, you know, who's going to pay that? Anyways, so that'll be sold. Porky's I will keep. Now, the rest was for me rummaging around the bins. The first thing is this, what's it called? An ink link handwriting system. It's just basically one of those things you clip to the top of your paper and you write on it and it records what you write, and then you can upload it to a computer or your Palm Pilot, for people who know what a Palm Pilot is. There's the inside of it. It's super clean. It had like extra pen writing bits and stuff. So it looks like it's never been used. I have no idea what it's gonna bring, if anything. I don't know what I paid for it. Everything you're gonna see total up to $36 Canadian. I just like old electronics and weird old oddware stuff, so this is right up my alley. I'll probably play around with that for a bit and see if I can sell it. Like I said, no idea what I'll get for it. Most of this stuff I haven't actually looked up yet. The next thing is this. It's called a Sable gaming keyboard. When I saw the Sable symbol, I thought it was maybe a Razer keyboard, because they have like the Razer Naga and the Razer Saga and stuff like that. But I didn't see that anywhere, so I think it's just a generic knockoff. I have no idea if it works. It's called a Hellboy 3 on the front. This I'm not going to sell. One of the clips is broken on the back here. Basically, what I'll use this for is just the next gaming computer I sell, or any computer I build to sell, I'll just bundle that in. Next thing I got, this is pretty cool. The belt on the back is a little trashed. That might affect it, but it's a Harley Davidson Bulldog. I checked the tag, it is pretty worn, but it's official Harley Davidson product. Again, I don't know if the camera will pick it up or how far back it is, but the belt on the back's a little worn here, but the fabric's all clean. It doesn't smell like smoke or sweat or stinky asshole or anything like that. So, I have no idea what it's going to bring. It might not be worth anything. It's Harley. It was official Harley, so I figured it's worth a try. I mean, worst case scenario, my son can play with it after I clean it. Next thing I got was more electronics. Now, there's the only reason I bought this. It's like a kid's, you know, you put your cassette tape in the front. Make your own radio stations. I used to have one of these. Coming up next, I thought I'd be like a radio host when I was a kid. Picks up radio stations. You can record the radio. There's some paint on it. Something shaking around in it, but the battery compartment looked really good. And it's got a cool cassette holder on the back to hold a blank cassette, which I'll probably include when I sell it. I'm gonna clean this up though, because there's paint splatter and scratches on the front. The reason I bought this, it says Music Wave on the front, but the reason I bought it, the back is ERTL, which I didn't know Ertl. I didn't know Ertl made stuff like this. Like, I knew they made die-cast cars, model cars, and certain toys and stuff. Never knew they made stuff like this, so it was just, it was neat. I couldn't pass it up. I didn't find the AC adapter, unfortunately, but I'll be able to put batteries in it. It takes like 4 size C batteries. Jeez. Old electronics into batteries. Next thing that was in the weigh-in pay Obviously, I grabbed this. Everyone should grab these if they're cheap enough. This is a Sony Walkman. It's G protection, does CD, CDR, W. It's model DEJ001. Something like this, without looking it up. Alright, sorry guys, I had a customer come in, so I'm not 100% sure where I left off. I know it was this Sony Walkman, $18 to $30 I would guess it would sell for without looking them up. This one's model number DEJ001. These and Panasonic Shockwaves, always worth grabbing. They always sell, and yeah, just, it is what it is. Grab them if you see them. The next thing, I don't know if it works, but after I show you all this, we'll do a little test, is a Canon ES10 electronic portable typewriter. I always buy typewriters. It has the ribbon in there. Again, I'm not sure if it's going to work. We'll find out. We'll test that in a minute. I don't know. I haven't looked this model up. The typewriters range anywhere from $50 to a few hundred dollars. It really depends on the model and the exact make. I've never sold a Canon one. I've sold some IBM ones. I've sold some Smith & Corona ones and Brother typewriters. All right, so now we're on to... I'm just going to put this beside me. Oh yeah, I got another plush. Don't know if it's worth anything. If you guys don't know what this is, it's Monster High. It's official Monster High. I don't know if this is still a thing, but for a while there, people went crazy for Monster High. All right, everything else I got. Oh, I got a file too. It's a little rusty. I'll clean it up with some WD. This isn't to sell. This is for me to keep. It's a Globe. It's a good file. So that's just for me. That's whatever. Next electronic I got. Buddy picked this up when I was at the Goodwill weigh-in pay. He looked at it and was like, what the hell is this? And threw it back. I knew exactly what this is. It's a handheld scanner. The bottom's a scanner. It's on wheels. So you put a piece of paper down and you just... And it scans the whole sheet. It saves it to an SD card or you can probably upload it right to a computer. I thought that was pretty cool. Again, it's called a... RAN Digital, I think. Scan on... Somebody wanted to know how to use it. Somebody probably couldn't read because on here it says like PDF JPEG and then there's a big sticker that says PDF JPEG. So I'm going to assume it was like an old person that just couldn't read the little writing. Whatever. So I don't know what that goes for. It was neat. Probably $10 to $20. Nothing crazy. Next is video games. Almost. I bought a DVD. Flight of the Conchords 2. If you guys have never seen Flight of the Conchords, I highly, highly recommend it. It's two New Zealanders that are basically in a band and they're just trying to make it in New York City and they make the funniest songs you've ever heard. They just randomly bust out into song. Super, super funny TV show. The one girl in there that's like their stalker, she's the voice of one of the girls in Bob's Burgers too, if you've ever seen that. Really good DVD. I actually bought this for myself because I don't have season 2. I have season 1. Super funny. Recommend watching it. This was for me too, I might as well show you. It's just the Offspring Greatest Hits. Yes, I have a couple CDs I kick around in the truck and stuff, but I don't want to go through my phone and find music. Next thing I bought was this 3-in-1-out? I think it's just 1-out. Yeah, 3-in-1-out video switcher. Has an S-Video composite. It's just a basic video switcher. This, I'm trying to set up a test spot at home in my basement, which I'll show you guys that tonight because I've been cleaning out my storage facility. Trying to, obviously because I'm losing my job, trying to get it all organized, and currently I'm just converting my basement into a, I guess, storage kind of work spot area. It sort of sucks because you have to duck when you're down there unless you're standing in between the rafters, your head fits in between them unless you're like over 6 foot. So it sort of sucks, but it works for now for storage. You know, I got everything on skids because it can get a little wet down there sometimes. And then in the near future, hopefully I'm going to get like a... 14 by 21 shed. We're going to insulate it, run hydro, convert that into a little workshop storage area. But anyways, this will probably just use for my little test TV downstairs. Run a couple outputs out of it because I got some multi-outs that will plug into multiple consoles. Just for kind of testing consoles, VCRs, crap like that. And yes, I could plug it into the back of the TV, but I don't like that because then I got to turn the TV every time. So the point is to have this in front of the TV and the wire goes around to the back of the TV and then I can just plug stuff in right here. So yeah, it's my method of thinking. Alright, let's go through these video games. Some of them aren't going to be worth anything. To be quite honest, a lot of them I'll probably keep that I don't already own. But you can expect anywhere from a couple bucks to 15, 20 bucks. First one, Ghost Recon Advanced Warfighter. It's complete, really nice shape. You probably only bring 8 to 10 bucks. Next one, The Elder Scrolls Oblivion. This one, probably about $15. It's in the box and everything. It's not too bad. Halo Combat Evolved. Again, these are all PC games. Probably only about a $5-$6 one. Fear, actually an excellent game. I already own the even bigger box copy of this. This one I could probably get $15 to $25 for. Don't quote me on any of these, guys. I'm going off the top of my head. Prices change all the time. If you want to make sure that you can make money off it, look it up yourself. Check the sold comps. Sims 2. Sims 2 open for business. I think there's Sims Superstar. Is there another Sims? Another Sims 2. What I'll probably do, there's the other manual. I'll lot all the Sims stuff together and yeah. I'll just sell it that way. Probably get $10 for it all lotted together. More Elder Scrolls. This is Morrowind. Elder Scrolls 3. It's a bit of an older one. What does this one run on? I think it's XP 98 era. Windows Me 98. So yeah, older. Oh, and XP in 2000. When did this come out? I'm curious now. It's been a long time. Probably 2000. Anyways, I'd probably get about $15 for that. Call of Duty Modern Warfare 4. Probably only worth a couple bucks. More than likely, you won't be able to use this online because Buddy probably used the activation key for Steam or something like that. Crysis, great game. This is like the joke if you had a computer back in the day. This is like the hardest thing to run. So still to this day, people are like, can it run Crysis? Even though it's like a freaking 10-year-old game now. Stupid hard. Pretty good game though. Couple bucks. Warcraft 3, again, couple bucks. Crysis Warhead, again, just a couple dollar game. Age of Empires 2 Gold Edition. Now we're getting into the older kind of Windows XP, Windows 98 gaming era. I'll probably get $18 for this. Original Bioshock. This one's like super clean. It's actually, I don't think it's been open. Or if it has, it's very well kept. This one, I don't know, probably $10, $8, something like that. And then I got this game I've never heard of called GT Legends from the creators of GTR. It's PC Gamer's editor choice, so it must not be that bad. Looks neat. Whoa, almost dropped it. Looks neat. It's older. 2000-ish, probably. Yeah, Windows 2000 era game. No idea what it's worth. I don't know, a couple bucks to $10. It came with the GTR disc too, though, which is the first game, so I'll lot all that together with some, I never looked what these are. And then just some random, it was called 9 Hours to Sun Up. It was like a random race game. No idea what it's worth. And then I bought this. Just because it's cool. It's a Cessna 172 Pilot's Guide. Again, I have no idea what this is going to be worth, but it's a Pilot's Guide. Probably something. And last thing I bought was just some audio cables. Some nice Monster ones, though, because I needed some audio cables. Also, if I find these like RCA versions or Component or S-Video, you know, the whole lot, or those very typical power plugs you see in the back of a lot of receivers and VCRs, I'll grab them and I'll throw them in a box wrapped up how they are so that when I sell a VCR, a DVD player, a stereo receiver, and, you know, the list goes on, I can include all the cables so they can just get it out of the box and hook it right up. Most people probably don't need the cables. They probably have this kind of crap laying around. But, you know, you're buying an old stereo receiver and you can put, it comes with Monster cables. People used to go nuts for Monster cables. So, yeah, that's it though. That's everything I bought. Yep, that is everything in the bag. I also got myself a big Costco bag. No idea if I'll make my money back. I bet the $36 I spent, though, I could make completely back just off the typewriter. I'd almost guarantee it. I'll look that typewriter up and test it, though, and show you guys if it works or not. And I'll show you my storage facility, because, oh my god, it looks like it exploded, basically, because I've been ripping through it and trying to clean it and organize it so that, yeah, I can get it empty. Anyways, guys, let's test this typewriter.
All right, guys, let's test this thing out.
A power button on the back somewhere, hopefully.
Yeah, there it is. Moment of truth. Oh, we got movement. All right, let's load some paper in, see if there's any ink left. Alright, this old girl looks like she's working. The erase ribbon's out. It has automatic erase on it, but that's not working. Yeah, everything seems to work. Shift buttons work, space works, turn works. Okay, really fast on this. Cool. So you guys can see. Whoa! Gotta turn my exposure down. There you go. So it did work. That's just where I tried the erase. I think it just strikes it out. Maybe it doesn't have the erase ribbon. Yeah, everything works on it though. It's a little dirty. Could use a wipe down and a bit of a cleanup. And while we're here, might as well check what this thing's worth. Canon ES-10. Come on, slow phone. Okay, nothing came up. Type writer. There we go. I was only getting inks and stuff. We can still buy lots of ribbons for them. Oh, there's a white one for, well, that's an ES5. That one's $96. Oops. Nothing active, and I keep getting a lot of camera lens stuff. ES10. Let's go to completed. Sorry guys, my camera is having a hell of a time focusing on the screen. There's a typewriter 10 in blue. Went for, that was different than mine, 54. We got there, typewriter 10, 32. Typewriter 10. Okay, so none of these are ES10s. Lots of typewriter 10s. No ES10. That might be one, right? No, that's not one either. So, 60. I'm going to put it at like 75 with a best offer and see if it sells, plus shipping. Pretty cool that it works. Just got to clean her up.